Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back to Clever TV. I'm Jocelyn Davis, hanging out in the lounge today with a big time movie star. It's Mason Cook. You guys are gonna get to see him starting this weekend in Spy Kids, All the Time in the World in 4D. I got it.
Finally.
I got it right. So this is like a reboot of a very popular movie series, obviously, that we've all seen. Kind of set up the movie for us and your character and how you fit in and stuff.
Well, it's sort of like a new generation of Spy Kids with the original Spy Kids also.
Cool.
Some awesome gadgets, talking robot dog, karate chopping robot dog, actually, to be exact.
Love it.
But I heard you want to hear about my character, so I'm gonna talk about that now.
Okay.
My character, Cecil Wilson, is a very smart, intelligent, and logical twin. He's very good at cracking code, solving anagrams, and hacking into computers and stuff. He's also hearing impaired, but to him it's not much of a disability. He actually uses it to his advantage to help stop the evil timekeeper.
Good stuff. Now, you mentioned that you're a twin.
Yes.
And I know Rowan has been in the studio. We love her. What was it like getting to work with her? And then, of course, your parents in the movie. Wow, talk about big-time celebrities, Jessica Alba, Joel McHale. Break down what it was like working with this team.
Well, getting to know Rowan, she's such a sweet person. She's very down-to-earth, very good actor, I have to say. I heard that this is her like first big movie, and I have to say she's pretty good.
I like that. I like to hear that.
Yes. But working with Jessica and Joel, probably Jessica was so sweet, so down to earth, very beautiful, an amazing actor. Joel was very funny. He was just like pulling jokes like on and off set. He actually picked me and Rowan up by one arm one night.
That's a good workout probably, right?
I was like, what? I was like, you look so weak and you can pick two kids up.
Check him out. That's why you guys are doing your superhero thing in the movie. You mentioned the evil timekeeper. So tell us what you can about the plot and what happens.
Well, the plot of the movie is Spy Kids introduces two new Spy Kids, brother-sister twins. My character, Cecil, of course.
Cecil.
Yes. And his sister, Rebecca Wilson. When they find out that their boring stepmom is really a retired spy who worked for the OSS and that their dog is really a robot dog who works for the OSS, and they're like all freaked out. And then once their mom gets thrust into action, they're thrust into action with her to help her save the world.
Wow. Do you ever wake up in the morning and wish that was your real life? Because that sounds so cool.
I know. I do actually sometimes. It's happened to me 3 times now.
3 times?
Yes.
Wow, can you tell me what happened?
I got up and I felt like I was sleep talking or like sleepwalking, and I just felt like I was punching people, and I ended up waking up and I was punching air in my bed.
It was a dream.
Yeah.
Oh man, well at least your dreams got to come true on the big screen, which is very cool.
Yes.
And you mentioned a little bit ago that the original Spy Kids, who we all fell in love with as, you know, in the first 3 movies, will be in this film as well. In what capacity, like how will they fit into the story, kind of?
Well, in the movie, they're sort of passing the torch down to Cecil and Rebecca. It's a very big part of the movie because, you know, they were the original Spy Kids, and now that they're passing the torch down to 2 new Spy Kids, I think it would be pretty cool for them. I mean, I've been hearing them tell me that it's so cool being a Spy Kid, and now that I am one, I have to say, they are correct on how it's so cool.
It's kind of like being a part of this very elite club of Spy Kids that are out there. And I know I asked you before we started shooting if you'd been recognized yet. So are you like prepared to walk down the street
and
people to like expect you to solve the biggest mysteries in the world?
Probably. I mean, I know I am because it's a lot of fun.
Definitely.
Like I don't get sick of it. It's because each person you meet is different, And they always ask you like a different question because every kid asks you a question. And probably the funniest question I've been asked, was probably at the Austin premiere. Some kid yells out, "Did the new Spy Kids have lots of fun?" That was probably the best question. And I said, "Heck yeah."
So fun, and there's so much action just in the trailer alone. What was it like shooting those scenes? Was that on a green screen, or were you actually out there doing all this crazy stuff?
Well, I really wish I was flying around in a luge around the city.
Ditto, except your character got a little queasy, right?
Yes, he's motion sickness. Mm-hmm. And I don't think a kid who gets motion sickness and then a rocket luge, they don't
belong together.
Yeah, they don't connect.
No. So what was it like shooting those things? Were those your favorites, or is there something else that stands out that we can look forward to?
Well, probably my favorite thing that I got to do when I was shooting the movie was probably getting to do all my own stunts. That was probably the coolest part.
No stunt double.
There was, but he was never used, and I feel really bad for him.
I'm gonna give you a high five for that, because, I mean, that's pretty impressive.
There's two reasons why I feel bad for him. One, because he never got to do anything, but the second reason, he always had to test out the things, and if it went wrong, he would be the one that it would be taken out
on. Right. Sorry, buddy.
Yeah.
We're just putting it out there on the record.
But
we're
luckily, he still lives.
He's still alive. He's still working.
Yes.
One of the last things I want to touch on is 4D. So we know about 3D. You put on the glasses. Stuff comes towards you.
You get kind of freaked out a little bit.
Yeah, but in a good way, of course. Yeah. What does 4D mean? Break that down.
4D, when you go to see Spy Kids, you'll be given a free Scratch and Sniff aromascope card, and it has 8 numbers. It's a really cool gift because it's like in big bold letters and it's in like little silver clock ears. It's so creative. and when a number comes up on the screen, you scratch that number and then you'll be able to smell what the characters are smelling in the movie.
I hope they're all good smells. I already said that, but I hope it's just flowers.
Oh,
they're
surprising smells. Probably my favorite smell is number 4.
Okay, so we're all gonna have to go check it out.
Just look forward to that.
So tell all of our viewers out there watching, because I know there's a lot of people who have been fans of this franchise for a long time, as well as new fans that are gonna be your age. Tell them out there why they should go see this movie and what they're gonna love about it.
Well, all you fans out there, you should go see the movie because it's action-packed, it's full of adventure, it has the original Spy Kids and some new Spy Kids and a karate chopping robot dog. And it's in 4D.
And it's in 4D. My goodness gracious. I kind of have a feeling like you guys, this new generation of Spy Kids, could there be another movie coming
out
the pipeline?
Yes, couldn't there be?
I have my fingers crossed.
Me too, because I don't even know, and I'm one of the new Spy Kids, and I have no idea. That's like top secret information for like Robert. Highly confidential.
Well, will you let me know when you find out?
Yes.
Okay, awesome. Well, thanks for coming by. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I also want to point out that I love your outfit.
Thank you.
Those boots are so cool. I wish that I could fit into them, but I don't think I can. Very cool. Well, hey, have a good time. Enjoy this moment in your career.
I will. And I enjoy every second of it.
Good for you. Take it all in. I love that. And all of you guys out there watching, make sure to check out Spy Kids. It hits theaters this weekend, August 19th. And of course, we here at Clever TV will be keeping you posted every single second. I'm Jocelyn Davis. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye, guys.